All too often, I think we very tritely use the term that something is the most important issue we're facing in the state today. But there's a reason that education is such a salient issue. There's a reason that we keep coming back to it. It's because of its importance. Its importance to somebody living the future that they deserve. Its importance to fundamentally equalizing our society, and the fact that Pennsylvania has failed to do so. As Deborah said, Pennsylvania is 44th in the nation in terms of overall state support for education. That, by the way, for those of you watching at home, is why our property taxes are so high. But even more importantly to this conversation, we are dead last in the nation in terms of the gap between our richest and poorest students. Nowhere is this more keenly felt in Pennsylvania than in my legislative school district. I have the honor of representing the 132nd Legislative District, which has the city of Allentown and South Whitehall Townships, also known as the Allentown and Parkland School District. Now, I'm a little bit biased here, but my wife is a teacher in the Allentown School District. She teaches at Harrison Morton Middle School in a building that was constructed in 1871, and she still teaches in classrooms that were constructed in 1871, when the Civil War was that thing that ended a couple of years ago. The reason that the Allentown School District had to close because of COVID and is only just now looking at reopening is because they didn't have the facilities that more modern, newer, and more suburban school districts did. My wife's HVAC system is an open window that sometimes opens. Compared that to the other side of Cedar Crest Boulevard, where Parkland High School was built in the 1990s, has separate wings for art, music, and gym, and is shaped like the Millennium Falcon. There is an inherent unequal system. If the kind of facility you go to and the resources that are available for every student depend on which side of Cedar Crest Boulevard that you live in. Now, again, as Deborah said, there is no area of Pennsylvania that is untouched by this. 65% of Black students, 58% of Latino students, and 58% of impoverished students attend schools in the 100 poorest school districts that could potentially be assisted by this Level Up plan. But I don't want to lose sight of the fact that this is not just an urban problem. This is one that also disproportionately impacts rural school districts. The list of the 100 poorest school districts in Pennsylvania is replete with dozens of rural counties, including districts like Blacklick Valley in Cambria, Laurel Heights in Fayette, and Rochester area in Beaver County. These are sparsely populated rural districts, and they are districts that have much more in common with Allentown, Philadelphia, and Reading than many people realize. House Bill 1167 would be a supplement to some of the other efforts to increase school district funding. The Level Up Supplement Fund would be created, and that would help to bring up these 100 poorest school districts. Our proposal would allocate an additional $100 million. Now, that is separate from the other BEF and SEF funding increases that are being done, that would go through a separate prorated formula, similar to the weighted BEF formula. This money would be prorated to the 100 poorest school districts. Now, there has been no shortage of ways to try to increase the funding to our poor school districts. The question in front of us then is, what makes this formula different? Why does this formula have a better chance of passing than others that have been attempted before it? The answer, candidly, is just how broad it is. The 100 poor school districts are in a Senate district of all 50 state senators and a majority of the members of the Pennsylvania House of Representatives. That means, at least in theory, that if a member was voting in the interest of their district, they would support this plan. The basic education funding formula that was enacted a few years ago is a truly fantastic formula. The issue is not the formula, but the money that's being put into it. It's worth noting that only 11% of the entire state educational spend falls under that formula. That means that while our poorest school districts are benefiting, they're not benefiting at a fast enough rate. The truth is that we talk a good game in Pennsylvania when it comes to the importance of educational funding. I've already read quotes today noting, correctly, that we've increased our overall share of the educational spend. That's not enough. Our words don't match our reality in terms of how we are taking care of the 100 poorest school districts in the state. For years, we have lived by a mantra in America that you can pull yourself up by your bootstraps, that all you need to be successful is a good work ethic and a great education. Let me say again, a great education. In the United States, in Pennsylvania, and the Lehigh Valley, we have been raised to believe the truth that a great education can be responsible for alleviating countless societal and individual ills. But the truth is that money matters, that funding matters, that how we invest in our kids matters. For education to truly be the great equalizer, we have to fund it equally. And that's what this Level Up plan will do.